Hey, what you watching?
Have you ever needed to dispose of a hard drive right now? Well, I've got a project for you that'll make even 5-minute crafts cringe. So, strap in and let's recycle those hard drives into something way more useful. Hint, it's a keyboard. Not that kind of keyboard. Or that one.
I actually found most of these hard drives lying around. However, I also managed to get my hands on this old PVR, which should have a nice old defunct hard drive in it. Unfortunately, it's rooted together, so I got up my drill. So I went and found my drill, and I'm ready to get drilling now. So I give it a go, and it is dead. So I went and charged my drill. And now that we're ready to drill, I went to the rivets, and it just slipped right off. Unfortunately, the domed head of the rivet is no match for the little drill. So I had to use some alternative methods, such as using a hacksaw, which worked really well. It did cut right through the rivet, but unfortunately, it basically just cut the rivet's head off, which isn't really what I'm going for. But then out of the corner of my eye, I saw the most magnificent thing, the tool of the gods, and I knew that I would be beaten by this PVR no longer. And then I broke the hard drive. I spent like an hour getting out of there.
But how do you turn a storage device into a speaker anyways? I mean, it's not exactly designed to be making sound. So if we look at a hard drive, we can see it's made of many different parts. The armature and a bunch of other parts that we don't care about. The armature itself is controlled by an electromagnet. So if I vary the current to this magnet, it'll make the armature flip-flop around like a fish out of water. Essentially, I'm just gonna put an audio signal via an amplifier into the armature and have it flip-flop around, and hopefully that'll make some sound. I mean, sound is just kind of vibrations after all. Check out Device Orchestra if you actually want to know how this works.
Alright, so here's my perfect prototype performing. Let's hope it does badly enough so as to fool YouTube's content ID. Sorry, did I say prototype? I meant final product. Anyways, let's gussy it up a bit, make 3 more, and slap it on piano. My expectations at this point are higher than the number of pictures I've stolen from the internet to make this video. Alright, so the first test of this thing. Audio is slightly noisy, but that's okay because it's all gonna go well and I'm never gonna use this clip. So I guess let's turn the power on.
Maybe there's a headphones button.
So as it turns out, this piano's headphone jack that I plugged into isn't actually just for the sustain pedal. Watch this. Why? All right, well, I guess it's time to go get a different piano.
Oh,
And that's the extent of my piano knowledge.
Now, if only I could actually play piano, that would be really great. But the good news is, with tons and tons of practice and extensive plastic surgery, you too can play the piano as well as this. Alright, well, I guess that's that. I'll see you in another couple of months for a video that really doesn't feel like it should have taken that long.